ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining me today. We have a film that I'm going to show you. It's about science gone wrong. A very popular staple of the 50s sci-fi genre. One of those films highly acclaimed by film enthusiasts and lovers of horror all around. Today, we're going to show you The Fly. Now, you're probably wondering, why would I want to see this movie? Most people know the David Cronenberg film, which I understand, but this was the original. This was a story so good that Playboy published it. But we're not going to talk about that just yet. Today, I'm going to show you and let you know what I think, how I feel about it, give you my review, and hope you guys enjoy. The Fly was based on a short story by George Langland, and of all places was published in the 1957 June issue of Playboy. Yeah, no joke. It's this one right here. It was adapted by screenplay writer James Clavell and directed and produced by Kurt Newman, who made quite a few Tarzan pictures and several other long-lost forgotten films. But one stood above the rest. The opening of the film, we see a man who's been crushed by a hydraulic press. Hell of a way to start. I was sort of taken aback by the amount of blood they've shown. For a 1958 audience, it might have been too much. This is probably why many of the cuts of the movie are in black and white. We cut to Vincent Price, who plays Francois Delambre, and his brother is Andre Delambre, who we'll talk about later. He gets a call from Andre's wife, Helen, who says she killed her husband. What? Price rushes to the scene of the crime and does verify that it is, in fact, his brother. He and the inspector, played by English actor Herbert Marshall, go to Andre's house and question Helen. However, she seems to avoid all the questions. We see Helen is very distraught after a maid tries to kill the fly, but we don't know why yet. The inspector and Francois come back to the house and are finally let in on what happened to her husband. Andre Delambre is a brilliant scientist who is working on a machine that can transfer matter from one place to another, essentially teleportation. After a few successful tests, he decides to try it on himself, but to his horror, he becomes a half-man, half-human fly creature. It's an unfortunate yet cautionary tale on how far science can go, and how a little mistake can leave a big impact on one's life. The build-up to the fly monster is well done and keeps you in suspense. Just the reveal of his hand is a bit jarring, and the reaction that Owens gives is great. Some might say it's cheap now, but I think for the time, it kept the audience in suspense, and it let them use their imagination to come up with what this creature might look like. A little time later, we see a close-up on the hand, and it looks like a hairy crab claw. Even though the actor doesn't talk when he transforms, he still conveys emotion, anger, sadness, and grief with the body language and hand gesturing. Even when he's knocking on the table, that's how he communicates with Helen because he can't speak. He's just saying yes or no. You can tell, though, through the knocking that he's sad, or that he's angry, or that he's distraught, and I think it's a telltale sign of a good actor. After a failed attempt of him going through the time machine, Helen, played by Owens, takes off the hood, revealing the fly head and a very well-done effects that show his kaleidoscope vision, and so he show you how he sees everything, kind of like the Predator or the Terminator for modern examples. We're given another great scream by Owens as she faints, letting the fly pick her up and lay her on the couch. After that, he thrashes around the room, destroying the time machine and burning all of his research. David Hedison does a great job portraying the monster, as like it's taken over his body, like a zombie or things of that nature. Finally comes full circle, and we're led back to the opening where we see her crush him with the hydraulic press, yes. After that, the inspector says she's crazy, and Vincent tries to find out where the fly is, and discover that it's Hedison's head, or Andre's head, on a fly body. But the bad thing is it's stuck on a spider's web, and call me a pussy, but I hate spiders and I couldn't look at that scene because it just looked too real for me. The character is also again played by Hedison, and I think due to a low budget, it's probably just a head and a man of fly bodies a little weak. I think they spent most of their effects on the actual fly head going on the actor, but I think this effect is a little weak. But to stop the spider, the inspector smashes it with a rock, killing both the doctor and the fly, and then the movie ends. I think I see how this one became a favorite of the 50s sci-fi genre. It's a great suspense and well-acted, well-shot, and all around a great film. I thought Price was going to be a more integral part to the story, but he was just more of a side character, but I think with Hedison and Owens acting, it really helped the film. There are two other sequels to The Fly, The Return of the Fly and The Curse of the Fly. And there's also the David Cronenberg film and the sequel to that, which is not directed by David Cronenberg. If you guys like me to review those and watch those and talk about them, please let me know in the comments below. But yeah, all I gotta say is I give The Fly 1958 a B+.
So that's what I thought of the movie, guys. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Took me a little bit to get it made. Like I said, we don't have any internet right now, but hopefully when we get the video out to you, we will have service and I will be posting more and more. Sorry to any of the viewers from TikTok. I'm not able to post right now because I don't have internet, so I'll be getting back on there. Again, I will put that link in the description below as well. Also, if you don't have the movie or if you want to check it out, definitely check it out, this film. I really do like it. It's a fun B-movie sci-fi film, and I think you'll really like it. So, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.